Police are investigating the scene of a devastating crash on Midland Avenue in Agincourt. Two teenage girls were struck by a car here around 3:30 this afternoon. One of them was rushed to hospital in life-threatening condition. And area residents say for years they've been concerned about this stretch of road.
Right now, I feel the children are in jeopardy, and it's going to happen again, and it's going to be worse.
The shattered windshield and mangled headlight on this vehicle, an indication of the force of the crash that sent two 13-year-old girls to hospital, one in life-threatening condition, the other in serious.
I still can't get over it. It's just so sad. Mm-hmm. I just hope that they get pulled through.
The Toronto District School Board tells us the two girls are in the 7th grade at Sir Alexander Mackenzie Senior Public School, a short 10-minute walk away from where they were hit. They were crossing Midland Avenue with a group of students at 3:30 this afternoon when it happened. Police spent hours on scene with the collision reconstruction unit trying to figure out exactly how the driver made contact with the two girls.
Still too early in the investigation to be able to determine if there's going to be charges laid or not.
Police say the driver is cooperating, and so far there's no indication of any criminality on her part. But area residents say speeding is a serious issue on Midland Avenue, and an incident like this was inevitable.
I feel horrible because I have two young daughters too, and the city won't do anything about it. We've asked to put up cameras. We're willing to pay for the cameras ourselves. The city's giving us a hard time so that we could catch these speeders. They don't listen.
You've noticed a lot of people speeding here.
Yeah, they speed around here all the time. They're going at 60, 70.
There are three schools in the area, including Agincourt Collegiate Institute and Agincourt Junior Public School. Hundreds of kids pour out onto the streets on a daily basis.
It's to the point where parents are shouting the cars, telling them to slow down, and they're not listening. They're just literally racing. And we've been fighting and putting up signs, and nothing seems to work.
We've heard there is a lot of speeding on this street. Is there anything more other than those electronic signs being done to keep an eye on this area?
My understanding is that there's a lot of enforcement being done on this road, and I myself do a lot of enforcement here when I was working out of this division. So we do our best, and whenever we have the manpower, we do put manpower in this area to enforce the speed law.
What is the speed limit here?
It's 40.
The Toronto District School Board tells us in a statement their thoughts are with the students and they are supporting the families in any way they can. They also say social work services are available for parents and students who are understandably upset.